The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1914, refreshing data with Power Query. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. As I mentioned yesterday, I was at Tulsa doing a live Power Excel seminar this week. And one of the features that I demoed that got a nice gasp from the audience was Power Query. Power Query is part of the Microsoft Power Business Intelligence stack. I have a little chart here that shows that stack. You know, we start with Excel, the product you already know and love. Power Query is for getting imperfect data into Excel. And the beautiful thing about Power Query is that it's free if you have Excel 2010 or Excel 2013. You know, you don't need Pro Plus or anything like that. So today I want to talk about Power Query. I'm just going to go to a brand new worksheet here, Control N. But to set this up, I want to get some imperfect data, and today the imperfect data is going to come from the website. All right, so here I am at flightstats.com. I'm just looking for a flight that is en route. This is from New York LaGuardia to Chicago O'Hare, and we're looking for something that is currently in the air. See position details. All right, so here we have a website that's going to be updated every minute. It's showing me the last 200 positional updates for the flight. And let's say that I need to get this data into Excel. So of course I could come here and I could select this whole table and copy and paste and then start to clean up the data. But I would have to clean up the data every minute when I refreshed. Okay, so here is the amazing thing about Power Query. I'm going to copy that URL, Control C. I'm going to come back to Excel, and on the Power Query tab, I'm going to say that I want to get my data from the web. Enter a web page URL. I'm going to do Control V to paste and click OK. And Power Query shows me that there are three different tables. Which table do I need? I don't know. But here's the beautiful thing. I just hover over a table and it shows me, oh, well, that's the header. That's the data I need right there. And then that's the footer. So right there, table one, choose that. And then down here at the bottom, say that I want to edit the table. All right, well, this is an ugly data set. If I copied and pasted this data in, we have three different time columns, and I really don't need that, so I'm going to choose the first one. And normally in Excel, I would right-click and choose Delete, but here I'm just going to say that I want to remove that column. Time of departure, so that's New York time, that's what I want to keep. Time of arrival, I'm going to remove that one. Speed, look at this, how evil they put the word KTS for knots in every single one. So let's see if I can split this data, split column, based on a certain number of characters. And I want to choose three characters once, as far left as possible. Click OK. And beautifully, they split it into the speed and then the word knots. So I'm going to choose that column and say remove. Altitude. Again, huge problems here because we have different number of characters. I can't just ask for the leftmost five characters. Now we have this word feet here, but check this out. This is a beautiful text to columns right here. I'm going to split it by a delimiter. And in the delimiter box, it's not comma, equal sign, semicolon. It's custom. And the delimiter is going to be the word feet, space feet, actually, at the leftmost delimiter. Click OK. All right, so now I actually have the altitude. And then here, again, this column will be one that I will remove this column. And then latitude and longitude, those are fine. Okay, the amazing thing about Power Query is that all of those steps that I just did, and they're not hard steps, any of us could have done those in Excel. You know, it's a couple of data text columns, right-click, delete, right-click, delete. You know, there's nothing amazing there. But when I did those steps in Power Query, they wrote program code in a new language called M. And that program code is remembered and stored as part of the query. It's certainly not necessary for you to do this, but if you were curious, you could come out here to View and Advanced Editor and actually see the M code that was created. All right, so we've done all the things we need to do. I'm going to click Apply and Close. And the data is now loaded into Excel, right? That's great. That's beautiful. Now, I'm going to pause the video and then restart the video. It's about 3 minutes later, and I've done one of my favorite tricks here that I do with data, the flight data, is tracked it in Power Map. in Excel 2013, one of the other pieces of the Power BI stack. And so right here is LaGuardia Airport, and you can see that every minute we have a position log of that flight. I can zoom out a little bit and actually track where the flight is. Today's video is not about Power Map. I've shown this on the podcast before. It's about Power Query. So let me pause again, and we'll just kind of take a look at the other end. So at the time that I ran the query in Power Query, the flight had spent some time over Pennsylvania and just crossed into New York, kind of heading in the direction of Buffalo, I would say. Now, those steps that I did and the M language that was created, if I wanted to go get an update and I was just using regular Excel, well, I go back to the website, I copy, I paste, I do all of those steps again. But here is the really beautiful thing about Power Query. About 5 minutes have elapsed since I originally did those steps. So I'm going to go back to Excel, and on the Data tab, I'm going to choose Refresh All. Power Query goes back out to the website, it pulls the data in, it does all of the steps that I did on the first go-round, and there we now have 6 new points. When I go back to Power Map, all I have to do is click Refresh Data. Now watch the end of the flight here. And bam, just like that, the flight is updated. Now, it's 10:47 a.m. I'm going to pause the video, and we're going to come back in about half an hour and refresh. Okay, half an hour later, back in Excel, data, refresh all. More data points. Power Map, refresh data. And that flight is passing over to Detroit Metro on their way to Chicago. Time to pause again. 15 minutes later, all right, they're on descent. Now look, the point here isn't that we're tracking some flight using Power Map. The point is, we do this all the time, right? The first day that you discover how to do something, it's really cool. You download that data, you do these steps, you do these steps. You don't write them down. Now, the second day that you do it, you're trying to remember, okay, what steps did I do the first day? And then the third day you do it, it starts to become a real drudge, and you have to document all the steps you do, so that way, from then on out, it's just, rote, follow the steps, and remember all the things that we did. But the beautiful thing about Power Query is I don't have to remember the steps. Right? Power Query watched the steps the first time, and then from there on out, it just becomes refresh all. And one last refresh, and we have the complete flight. Power Query is absolutely free if you have Excel 2010 or Excel 2013. You don't need any Pro Plus or anything special like that. There are amazing, amazing features in Power Query. You know, this was just ugly data. Every day I'd have to refresh this, or actually every few minutes I had to refresh this. And do a whole bunch of steps. But thanks to the M language, we were able to just simply remember clicking refresh. Power Query, one of the great features of the Microsoft Power BI stack of products. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.